Hello friends and my dear students, welcome back to my channel Phoenix Physics. Today we are going to discuss example 1.19. In our previous video we discussed about electrostatic induction. Based on the concept, this problem is given. A small ball of conducting material having a charge plus Q and mass m is thrown upward at an angle theta to the horizontal surface with an initial speed V naught. There exists a uniform electric field E downward along with the gravitational field G. Calculate the range, maximum height and time of flight in the motion of this charged ball. Neglect the effect of air and treat the ball as a point mass. What is given? The charge of the ball is given, that is plus Q. Mass of the ball is given, that is M. Initial speed is V naught. Here E acts downwards. What is this E? It is nothing but uniform electric field. Here uniform electric field acts downwards along with the gravitational field. Then how do you calculate the total acceleration? Here we have two kind of acceleration. One is due to our earth gravitational field, another one is due to this uniform electric field. So just add these two field, you can get total acceleration. So the total acceleration is equal to acceleration due to gravity G plus acceleration due to electric field E. Let us calculate one by one. The acceleration of a charged ball due to gravity is G, that is equal to minus Gj vector. Here what is J vector? J vector is nothing but a unit vector. I and J are the unit vectors act along x axis and y axis. Suppose if you throw a ball, it attracts towards the ground downwards, right? So G acts downwards, that is why I have put minus sign here. Downward direction, that is negative y direction, that is why j cap. So minus gj vector. This is for acceleration of charge ball due to gravity. Next, acceleration due to electric field E. See, here I have charged ball. If it is uncharged ball means it has only mass, but here I have charged ball. Suppose if you place a charge in an uniform electric field, it will accelerate. That is why we are calculating acceleration due to electric field. According to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. Here we need only acceleration. So acceleration is equal to F by M. Here what is F? You know the formula, F is equal to EQ. So just to substitute, EQ divided by M. Here the electric field acts outward, so negative y direction. That is why I have put minus sign here. A is nothing but a unit vector acts in the y axis. The total acceleration means just add these two acceleration, take minus outside, G plus QE by M, J vector. Here acceleration is a vector quantity. Suppose I want only magnitude, means you need not worry about the plus or minus sign. So you can simply take it as G plus QE by M term alone. Why? Because I am taking only the magnitude of G. So magnitude of A is equal to A or G, both are same. So here I am calculating only the magnitude of acceleration. So A is equal to G plus QE divided by M. What they asked? Calculate the range, maximum height and time of flight. What is range? Range is nothing but maximum horizontal distance between the point of projection and the point at which the object hits the ground. We have already studied this range, maximum height and the time of flight formula in our 11th standard itself. just apply the formula alone. So R is equal to V square sin 2 theta divided by G. What is V? V is nothing but initial speed. Our initial speed is V naught. So simply you write it as V naught square sin 2 theta divided by, instead of G, you substitute this one. So G plus QE divided by M. Next one, maximum height. Which one is maximum height? This is our maximum height. So the maximum vertical distance, this is range means maximum horizontal distance, H max means maximum vertical distance. So H max equal to V square sin square theta divided by 2G. Here V is nothing but our initial speed. So V naught square sin square theta divided by 2 into G is G plus QE divided by M. This is our H max formula. Finally, time of flight. What is time of flight? The time taken by the projectile from the point of projection till it hits the ground. So time of flight formula, TF is equal to 2V sin theta divided by G. Sin theta divided by, instead of G you substitute G plus QE divided by M. This is time of flight formula. So we calculated range, maximum height and time of flight. From these result we can conclude 3 points. First one, R. What is R? Range, maximum height, time of flight. All are inversely proportional to G. See, R is inversely proportional to G. H max is inversely proportional to G. TF is inversely proportional to G. This is our first point. Second point. Suppose I have positively charged object. Plus Q object means A becomes G plus QE by M, which is greater than G, right? G. The object has only mass alone. It is an uncharged object, means it has only mass, the net charge is zero. In that scenario, A is greater than G. So R, H max, TF will decrease. Suppose I have negatively charged ball, means A becomes G minus QE by M, which is lesser than G. Okay, so what is this G? Suppose you have only uncharged object. Uncharged object means net charge is zero. It has only mass. In that type, it has only G. If it is charged object means we have this extra quantity. If it is uncharged object means we have only G alone. That is the meaning. In that case, R, H max, TF will increase when compared to the motion of the object of mass M and zero net charge. What is the meaning? Here we have only uncharged object. Based on the result, we have plotted this graph. Here the projectile makes an angle theta with the horizontal axis. Here we have three types of curve. One is for plus Q charge, another one is for zero charge. Zero charge means it has mass alone. The net charge is zero, which means uncharged particle. So Q is equal to zero. And the red line indicates, suppose if we have negatively charged object, means the path is like this. Whether it is positively charged particle or negatively charged particle or uncharged particle, the graph is parabolic. I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my video, please share and subscribe my video. Thank you.